Hello students, today we are going to learn about prepositions. Okay, so before starting my video, I'm going to ask you one question, that what makes you beautiful? What makes you look beautiful? Yes, makeup? No, wrong. Any powder? No. See, your inner beauty makes you look beautiful, whether if you are black or white or if you are fair or dark. That's not the problem. If your inner beauty is very pure, you will look automatically lovely and beautiful. So what is inner beauty? Inner beauty means what? Your conscience, right? Your thoughts which are willing to help others, right? Our good thoughts make us look beautiful. So whenever you wanted to help others, don't think about twice, you can help others, okay? So whenever when we come to the topic of helping, you should never think about twice. You need to happily, you need to help others, okay? So only your inner beauty makes you beautiful, children. Keep in your mind. So always don't think about any bad idea, or you should not think bad thoughts about others, okay? Always think positive and be positive and also help others. So this was the short motivational thought I wanted to give you. So let's start learning about the preposition, okay? So as I said, in this video you are going to learn about prepositions. So what do you mean by preposition? In class 3 itself you may have learned about what are prepositions. Yes, the name itself has the meaning. See, preposition, it ends with the position. So it may be like it is going to talk about the position of something only. So what kind of position it is going to talk, let's learn, okay? So let me read out the definition for you. It tells us, prepositions are used to tell us about the position. What? Yes, position of things or people. So it is going to be tell us with the help of some words, it is going to tell us about the position of the things or people, where the thing is or where the people is, okay? For example, you can look at the picture. What can you see? Here, what can you see in the picture, children? Yes, here, there is a round table, right? Just imagine this is a round table, and on the round table, I have kept one mug, okay? And then you can see one person, and then here you can see a ball, and here there is a tab also, okay? Now you need to tell me the position of these things. Where are these things? Where is the cup is? Okay, where is the mug is? It is on the table. You can tell me like it is on the table. So the word on tells us the position of this cup. Okay, I can also say cup or mug. Okay, so it tells us about the position. With the help of on only we can get where is the mug. Okay, where is the mug? On means what in Tamil? Yes, mele. In the cup ipa enga irukku, idu vandu table ku mele irukku, mele irukku. So mele, that word is the preposition. Are you getting the answers, children? Yes, prepositions are used to tell us about the position of things only. See, the cup is on the table. And can you see the person? Where is the person? He is in front of the table. He is in front of the table. And the table is not table ku munnadi and the person nikkranga. So the word which I used to point out the position of the person. Yes, that word, that is in front. So I'm going to write in front of, okay, in front of. So the word in front of is used to point out the position of this person. And where is the ball, children? Yes, the ball is under the table. Ball enga irukku? Table ku adila irukku. Then adila in English what? Very good, that is under. U-N-D-E-R, under, okay? So it is under the table. The word under is the preposition. And what about the tap? Where is the tap? Yes, the tap is behind the table. You can look at the picture. It is backside only, right? So behind, behind means what? Pinnadi irukku, okay? Pinnadi. So the word behind stands for preposition. So children, what are preposition? Only these words. See, behind, on, under, in front of and many other thing, many other words which are help us to find the position of things or the people. One more example I can tell you, where is the pen? The pen is my in my hand. And you can also, I can also ask you that where is the whiteboard? Where is the whiteboard? It is behind me, right? Behind, the word behind also stand for preposition only. Okay children, so I can give you more example, just imagine there is a tree. Okay, on the tree there was a monkey. So how can I say, see, the monkey is on the tree. Okay, so more other words, those words which are help us to find the position of the things or people are called preposition only. So example here also I have written, that is on, above, under, near, between, in. So on means what we know, that is mele. Above also stand for the same meaning, mele. Under means adile. Okay, near means pakkathile, arugil. Between means nadule. In means ulle. Okay, so in the mari position ah solradhu ulle irukku enga irukku and thing enga irukku adu vandu adukku keela irukku illa mele irukku adukulla irukku. So idho indha mari nam solrom bodhu use pandra words irukku illaya position ah solradhu, that is only called as what children, preposition. So I hope you are clear with this topic, that is what are preposition. Keep in your mind only the keyword is position. So preposition help us to find the position of things or people only children. Okay, and there are some three type of preposition. Okay, how many type of preposition we are going to learn? We are going to learn the three type of preposition. What are the three type of preposition? They are preposition of time, preposition of place, preposition of direction. See, there are three types of preposition. They are preposition of time, preposition of place, and preposition of direction. So these are the three type of preposition which are going to help us to find the position of, with what are the words we can point out the preposition of time. Okay, when we are talking about the time, which preposition, which words we need to use to talk about the position, and for the place also, which are the words we need to use, which are the preposition. Okay, preposition are the words only. Okay, which are the preposition words we need to use to point out the place. At last, for pointing out the, for talking about the position of direction, no? So which are the preposition can help us to find the position of this direction? So how many type of prepositions are there children? Yes, there are three type of preposition, and they are preposition of time, preposition of place, preposition of direction. Okay children, and we have learnt about the definition of preposition in this video, and in the next video I will be telling you about the type of the preposition. We are going to learn one by one about the prepositions time. So I'll see you in the next video children. Thank